Hello and welcome to Excellence Academy. Let's look at the second method of differentiation known as first principle. My second method here, first principle method of differentiation. So what then is the principle behind first principle? What's the idea behind first principle? I'll just take an example and we explain together, right? All right, so example one, under first principle. Let's say I have y being equal to x. From the idea of general method we've done before now, I'll have that this will give you one. Here's the concept. I'll have that the y over the x is equal to, we said, multiply by the power. The power here is one, so it becomes 1 times x into what's there? 1 minus 1. This is equal to 1 times x into 1 minus 1 is 0. That's now equal to 1 times x plus 0 gives you what there? 1. 1 times 1 is 1. This is the general method of solving this question. If I'm to use first principle method, what do I do? What's the concept of first principle? Now, here's your idea, please. For first principle, from this function, your first case is to add change in y to y and then add change in x to x. So I'm having y here, it becomes y plus, I said to y, add change in y is now equal to, here is x. I said for x, add change in x, it becomes x plus change in x. So it's simple enough, to y, add change in y, to x, add change in x. Next up, I'll move y over here. So I'll have that change in y is equal to x plus change in x. Here's a plus y, comes and becomes what there? Minus y. Next up, I'll substitute the value of x from this point here, but we just said from here that y is equal to what there? X. Hence, I have that change in y is equal to x plus change in x minus y. What's y? Y is x, it becomes x. From this, it becomes x and minus x. So x cancels minus x. I'll have that change in y is equal to change in x. So next up, divide through by change in x, it becomes all over change in x, all over change in x. And this is now equal to change in x over change in x gives you what there? 1. So this is the answer. Remember, when I did this using general method, I had 1. So using first principle, I'm still seeing 1. So this is the simple concept behind first principle method of differentiation. Take another example under first principle. So under first principle, let's take example two. Let's say I'm given y being equal to x squared. From this, if I use general method, obviously I'll have that dy over dx is equal to what there? 2x. But let's do this man using first principle method. So what's the idea here? So we said, don't forget, we said from this, we said to y, add change in y, to x, add change in x. So use this concept here. It becomes, I'm having y, so to y, I'll add change in y is equal to, I'm seeing x, so it becomes x plus what there? Change in x. But what do you notice? Notice that unlike in this case here, for this x, the value is squared. So it becomes x plus change in x, I will square this. Reason being that my x value here was squared, so it becomes this squared. All right, work on this. I'll have to expand this. I have that y plus change in y is now equal to, if I expand this using binomial expansion, this will give you x squared plus 2x dx plus, this gives you dx squared. That's using the concept of binomial expansion, or perhaps Pascal's triangle, to do this expansion. But for the sake of teaching, let me expand this separately. So I'm seeing here as x plus change in x all squared. When something is squared, it means it is multiplying itself. So it now becomes x plus change in x multiplying x plus change in x. This is this squared multiplying itself. This is now equal to, so the concept here is to use each of the terms in the first bracket to multiply all the terms in the second bracket. Use each of the terms in the first bracket to multiply all the terms in the second bracket. So I'll take this first term here, x, multiply everything here, x plus change in x. Take the second term here, plus change in x, multiply everything here, x plus change in x. So take each of the terms in the first bracket, multiply everything in the second bracket. This is now equal to x times x gives you x squared plus x times change in x gives you, please mind you, it will not give you change in x squared. No, we are assuming that x and change in x are two different things. So you can't say x times change in x equal to change in x squared. That would be wrong. So it becomes x change in x instead. So x times change in x gives you x change in x and not change in x squared. This would be wrong, please. So I'm having x times change in x is x change in x plus same concept here. Change in x times x gives you the same thing, x change in x. So I'm having x change in x plus change in x times change in x gives you change in x squared. If I work on this now, it's equal to, I'm having x squared. These two are like terms, so they can add up. So x change in x plus x change in x gives you two of it. So it becomes plus 2x change in x plus finally change in x squared. And this is how I arrived at this answer. All right, next up, if you refer to the previous example, we said at this point, after your expansion, I'm done with my expansion here. After this now, I'll move the value of y over here such that I'll have that change in y is equal to, this is x squared plus 2x change in x plus change in x squared. I'm having a plus y here, moves over here, becomes what now? Minus y. So it becomes minus y. But I already have a value for y. But we said y is equal to what? X squared. So it becomes equal to x squared. From here, y is equal to x squared. Hence, I will have that change in y is equal to x squared plus, I'm having this as 2x change in x plus change in x squared minus y. What's y there? X squared. So it becomes minus x squared. From here, I'm seeing x squared. I'm seeing minus x squared. So this one here would cancel this. And I'm left with change in y being equal to 2x change in x plus change in x squared. At this point now, I'll divide through by change in x. So if I divide by change in x, I'm dividing each of the terms by change in x. So it becomes change in y all over change in x is now equal to, here becomes 2x change in x all over change in x plus, I'm having here as change in x squared all over change in x. All right. If I work on this now, I'll have that change in y all over change in x is now equal to, from here now, this cancels this. I'm left with 2x becomes 2x plus, from here now, this is 2 of it. That's why it's squared. This cancels this. I'm still left with change in x. So it becomes plus change in x. Notice the difference between this example and the first one. For the first one, after doing this, I had just x there. Oh, so I had just 1 there. In this case now, after getting your change in y over change in x, if you still have a change in x here, what do you do now? I'll take limit. So I'll take the limit of changing x as being equal to 0. Please notice I said after getting your change in y over change in x, if you're still having a value of change in x here, what do? Simply take the limit of change in x at 0. In simple terms, where I see change in x, put what there? Put 0. So this is now equal to, I'm having 2x plus what here? This becomes what? 0. I'm having 0. So I have that change in y all over change in x is equal to 2x plus 0 gives you 2x. So observe the same value as I had when I did my general method. So this is the idea of first principle method of differentiation.